Welcome to the story of the element girl Oxygen from the Magical Periodic Table and the Element Girl series, book 4. In this story, you will meet Oxygen from family 16 or the Chalcogen family with atomic number 8. Breathless, I sprinted along the sidewalk with my pet dog Electron keeping pace as we headed toward my friend Mole's residence. Nestled in the backyard was her home, adjacent to her mother's herbs and greens nursery. Catching my breath, I exclaimed, "Air, that's what I need." Mole eagerly responded, "Let's pay a visit to Oxygen." Soon, we laid out the periodic table on a wide wooden table under an oak tree. Pointing to Oxygen, I said, "Oxygen is in family 16, the Chalcogens." Knitting her brows, Mole asked, "Chalcogens?" Nodding, I replied, "The word originates from the Greek word chalcos, which means ore forming, since the elements in this family are found in the ores of copper. I was reading about it the other day." Next, we debated whether to leave Electron in the yard with Mole's mom. Mole shared, "Oxygen has high electronegativity. In science class, we learned that chlorine ranks highest in electronegativity, followed by oxygen. Given oxygen's need for 2 electrons to complete the valence shell, the element girl might mistake your pet dog Electron for a genuine electron." "That is a smart point," I acknowledged, and we opted to leave Electron in the nursery. She happily explored the expanse of space, reveling in the array of enticing scents. Then we pushed down Oxygen on the periodic table. The trees and the plants whirled about around us. Soon we found ourselves surrounded by tall redwood trees, birds, squirrels, and even deer. We were standing on a trail near a creek, with the sound of the running water all around us. With a big smile on our faces, we started walking on the trail by the creek, wondering where we were. A gentle, calming breeze enveloped us, accompanied by a melodic chant, echoing through the giant redwood trees. "O2, O2, O2. Intrigued, we followed the sound and entered a small clearing where a girl sat in meditation, O2 symbols emanating from her fingertips. As she slowly opened her eyes and greeted us with a warm smile, a sense of well-being filled my lungs. In a melodic tone, she expressed, "Welcome to Muir Woods. I am Oxygen." Dressed in a bluish tie-dye shirt and yoga pants, she sat amidst plants and creepers, with the creek water splashing nearby. Mole and I exclaimed in unison, "Oh, we are in Muir Woods." Memories flooded back of our families visiting this national monument a year ago for a day of hiking and communing with nature. Oxygen shared, "This is one of the best places on earth for me. Did you know these trees range from 400 to 1,000 years old? They are the tallest living things in the world." Eyes wide in amazement, we gazed at the towering trees. I felt a sense of humility and gratitude. Mole, whose dream was to work with plants and trees, had tears of joy in her eyes. Oxygen quietly said, "In the presence of sunlight, all these trees and plants absorb carbon dioxide and water, make glucose for their energy, and release oxygen during a process called photosynthesis." Then, using a small wooden twig, she started writing the balanced chemical equation for photosynthesis on the ground. 6CO2 plus 6H2O plus light energy gives C6H12O6 plus 6O2. Oxygen explained, 6 molecules of carbon dioxide and 6 molecules of water combine in the presence of light to form 1 molecule of glucose and 6 molecules of oxygen. No wonder the air here is so clean and refreshing. Breathing in the crisp, clean, cool air, I added. Our lungs take in the air. Then the oxygen from the air is taken into the cells where it combines with glucose to make carbon dioxide, water, and energy. The carbon dioxide is exhaled out by the lungs. The chemical reaction called respiration that keeps us all alive and filled with energy. Oxygen grabbed another twig and wrote the balanced chemical equation for respiration. C6H12O6 plus 6O2 gives 6CO2 plus 6H2O plus energy. Then she explained, 1 molecule of glucose combines with 6 molecules of oxygen to form 6 molecules of carbon dioxide, 6 molecules of water, and energy. Cellular respiration occurs in the cells of living things to release energy stored in glucose for various cellular functions. I exclaimed, the chemical equation for cellular respiration is the exact reverse of the chemical equation for photosynthesis. Moore asked, during the pandemic, people were buying some kind of a device to monitor their oxygen levels. Could you please explain? Oxygen responded, the device is called a pulse oximeter, which can be clipped onto a person's fingertip. It measures the oxygen saturation of hemoglobin in the arterial blood. Monitoring blood oxygen levels helps to assess the severity of respiratory illnesses and guide medical decisions. I asked, what would happen if there is not enough oxygen in the blood? Oxygen replied gravely, oxygen is crucial for various physiological processes. A condition known as hypoxemia, which is oxygen deficiency, can have serious consequences for the body's normal functioning. Lack of oxygen can lead to tissue damage, and if prolonged, may cause organ failure. The heart, brain, and kidneys are particularly sensitive to oxygen deprivation. Moll and I cried out, wow. Looking at the two equations, oxygen proudly remarked, photosynthesis is the most important chemical reaction on Earth, and respiration, another essential exothermic reaction. Then she started walking on the trail, with us following her. Spreading her hands around, she said, I am the third most abundant element in the universe. Hydrogen, my good friend, being the first, and the noble helium, the second. I am the second most abundant element in the atmosphere, about 21%. And I take the first place for abundance on the Earth's crust. I said aloud, I wonder what would happen if there is too little or too much oxygen in the air. Gazing up at the redwood treetops, oxygen answered, you may have heard about mountaineers carrying oxygen tanks. At higher levels, there is less oxygen and breathing becomes difficult. You may want to research and read about high altitude sickness. People who do deep sea diving, go in submarines, etc., also need to carry oxygen for life support. When we reached a clearing, she paused and turned around to face us. Then she said in a firm tone, please step away from me for a few minutes. To our utter astonishment, flames started erupting in her hair as if it was on fire. Standing motionless, she explained, if there is too much oxygen, things can spontaneously catch fire. As you see, I am a supporter of combustion. It is a type of chemical reaction where a fuel combines with oxygen to produce carbon dioxide and water and energy. The fire magically died down, and she was her calm, cool self again. She then grabbed a twig and wrote the chemical equation for combustion. Fuel plus O2 gives CO2 plus H2O plus energy. Then she explained, the fuel combines with one molecule of oxygen to form one molecule of carbon dioxide, one molecule of water vapor, and energy, another important chemical reaction. I asked, my dad always applies lemon juice to apple slices to prevent their oxidation and browning, as he calls it. Could you please tell us more about this? Oxygen nodded and replied, when the fruit is cut or bruised, the cell walls are damaged and the cellular contents come into contact with oxygen in the air. The enzyme polyphenol oxidase present in the cells of many fruits becomes activated in the presence of oxygen. This enzyme is a catalyst and it speeds up the oxidation of phenolic compounds that are naturally present in fruits. This oxidation reaction leads to the formation of brown pigments called melanins. While the appearance may be less appealing, the fruit's taste and nutritional content are usually unaffected. The ascorbic acid in lemon juice works as an antioxidant and inhibits the oxidation process and the resultant browning. Then Mole asked, can you please tell us the difference between O2 and O3? Oxygen resumed walking and replied, have you learned about covalent bonds? We answered affirmatively. She continued, good. So since oxygen is a nonmetal with 6 valence electrons, the bond between 2 oxygen atoms is a double covalent bond. Thus, the oxygen gas exists as O2 in the atmosphere. O2 is necessary for living things to survive. Ozone, O3, on the other hand, is an allotrope of oxygen. It is less stable than O2 and is typically found in the Earth's stratosphere, and it forms the ozone layer. Ozone plays a crucial role in absorbing and blocking ultraviolet, that is UV radiation, from the sun. And it basically protects us from getting skin cancer. By then, it was almost noon, and we had walked all the way back to her place of meditation by the creek. We still had so many questions to ask her. Eagerly, I asked, could you share more about the practical applications of oxygen, please? Alongside the creek, she retrieved items from her knapsack, a rocket, a lengthy splinter, and a labeled balloon filled with hydrogen. A long string was tied to the balloon. She held the string to the balloon as it rose up. Then she instructed us to step back. Oxygen said, there is hydrogen in this balloon, and there is oxygen all around the balloon. What happens when you set flame to hydrogen and oxygen? Without waiting for an answer, she ignited the lengthy splinter and touched it to the balloon. In an instant, a mini explosion ensued, and our startled screams echoed through the air. Oxygen took a twig and started writing on the ground again. 2H2 plus O2 gives 2H2O. As she finished writing, Mole explained, 2 molecules of hydrogen combine with 1 molecule of oxygen to form 2 molecules of water and lots of energy. Oxygen nodded and added, this reaction is a combustion reaction and is commonly known as a combustion of hydrogen. It is an exothermic reaction and releases much heat energy. This reaction is used to propel rockets and also is a key aspect of fuel cells, where hydrogen and oxygen react to produce electricity and water in a controlled manner. We cried out, hydrogen and oxygen together make water, and lots of energy is given out, How cool is that? We applauded and Oxygen beamed. Oxygen remarked, the interactions between water and oxygen are fundamental to life on Earth. From supporting various ecosystems to participating in chemical reactions and biological processes, the relationship between water and oxygen is critical for the functioning of our planet. Realizing that it was time for us to take leave, we thanked her profusely. Then Mole asked her, one more question, please. Why are you wearing blue? Pointing to her simple outfit, Oxygen said, oxygen gas is colorless, but liquid oxygen at cryogenic temperatures is pale blue. That's why I wear blue. Thanking her again, we started walking away from the creek. In a few seconds, we found ourselves back in the nursery backyard. Mole's mom was busy with customers while Electron peacefully napped under a tree. Gathering fresh greens, vegetables, and berries, we crafted a wholesome salad. Paired with a peanut butter sandwich and green tea, we relished our meal. Even Electron indulged in a peanut butter sandwich. As we sipped the green tea and breathed in and out, we fondly recalled our encounter with Oxygen. Happy learning. Thank you. If you find value and learning in this content, please subscribe, like, and share, enabling other students to benefit from this free resource as well.